While judging from your applause, you're all enjoying the evening as much as I am. So we have come to a very special part of the program. A few members of the company have agreed to share their memories and experiences of their special time whilst in the Met Chorus. So to begin this section, we would like to invite Father Nilo Malusa to come front and center, please.
You see, at the Met, I have two most memorable experiences. First was during audition. I was not going to audition because my best friend was going to audition and he needed moral support. So then it was, I joined him, we auditioned. The next day, I was called back. Thanks to Doctora. Doctora was doing everything. I was so afraid. It was my first time. I was 17 years old. I was first year college. And I had no idea in singing because I was not a voice major. I was taking up composition. So I was there auditioning. And then when I was summoned the next day, I said, bakit ako, hindi naman ako nag-audition yung best friend ko. Ano sasabihin ko sa kanya? So what happened was, we had rehearsals. And the most wonderful experience rehearsing with Doctora, I had a chance to experience choral singing at the highest degree. Because we were, should I say, coerced, forced to really sing. Not only sing, but you know, at the Met, we were taught not only to sing, but we were taught to act, to dance, and perform on stage. Which means, you have no choice but to subject yourself to all these humiliations. But we enjoyed it. All of us were enjoying it. Not the humiliation part, but we were enjoying performing for the people. And my first paycheck, I had to treat my best friend. And the second very unforgettable experience for us, of course, we're undergoing all these things. Of course, there were good ones, and I was one of the backup singers. When we had this other engagements besides singing at the Met, one of the engagements was singing at the Top of the Hilton, for those who can still remember Top of the Hilton. Doctor would have a quartet singing there for lunch, for dinner, and unfortunately, one of those lunches, these four soloists were required to attend the rehearsal with the director on stage. So she had to get replacements for the four soloists. And unfortunately, I was picked on using them. Of course, I know the repertoire is not a problem. The only problem was, during the actual scene, I said, eh, dito iba ba yung key ng Kalesa? You know Kalesa, the song by Natalie Cueto. Sabi ko, I am not secure with the high soul for the soloist since I'm going to do the solo. And then the rondale, it's like music. Hindi na kaya mo yan, tayo man, sige. So I was singing there. And when it came to that part when I was going to reach the soul, someone walking, kill! Then Yvette, she wasn't her mom there. Yvette did this in her mom. I wanted to melt it in there. But I continued singing. Come, I just smiled and then went on with the program. At the end of the show, I stayed in the dressing room until everybody was out of the hall. But in spite of that, I learned two things. First, Doctora, I enjoyed singing very much. Thank you very much for the experience. And number two, I've proven myself not to be a good soloist. Ever since I never sang solo, I apologize for those expecting me to sing here during our masses. I do not want to because I do not want to repeat the performance of doing that again. I'm trying my best to sing for you as much as I can. Doctora, thank you very much for the experience.
Thank you very much, Father Nilo. We would now like to call on Father Benio Fajota.
When I joined the Met in late 1980, I still had the hair on my head. And my most unforgettable experience with the Met Chorus was outside the Met. It was a production of the Met. Kagagawa lamang po ng PICC at that time. And there was an international convention. And on the last night, they were treated to a musical extravaganza kung fashion show with the late Miss Lumen David. And you know, pag at the end of the fashion show, mayroon pong finale doon ay yung bride lalabas, no? Yung bridal gown. And then, ako yung piniling kumanta ng solo, papiraso lang. No? While the bride is coming in, there was this background song of Miss Felita Corrales. It was a an original song composed by Butch Montserrat, I think, if I remember it right. And I was given that piece for me to study just a few days before. And doktora, ang meaning ko, ayoko nang kanta. Masyado mababa para sa akin kahit base 2 po ako, I found it very low. And I, parang hindi ko type yung melody, no? So, ganun pa man, no? The model was very tall, she was 5'10". And naka-heels pa, so I had to step on a platform. So while she was coming in, there was this background song. Pagdating niya, paglapit niya sa akin, I had to sing my solo part. And from then on, no, yung pong kinakanta ko, kinakabahan ako, talagang sobra ang kabog ng titil ko. After the song, the last note was off-key. 2,000 delegates from all over the world. Not a single applause. Andun po yung mga kasama ko sa chorus, nakatingin sa akin, they were so stunned. Hindi rin sila nakapalakpak. And I thought to myself, it was a very, very, talaga para sa akin, grabbing experience. And I thought to myself, kasi right after that portion, it was supposed to be the grand finale. Masayang-masaya, no? Lahat nakapasok ako, nagmumukmuk sa backstage. Sabi ko, at least for the effort, I should have been given an applause. Do you agree? Yeah, 33 years after, nakuha ko yung aking palapas. Thank you. And similarly, just like Father Nilo, mula po ng experience na I was so traumatized, I never sang solo in public. Nalakas po ang loob ko pag grupo, pero talagang hindi ako naglakas ng loob na kumanta ng solo. So, Doktora, Tito Chingay, Tito Chingay lang na mayo, I saw Mr. Numerson right after the mass. Na, and Doktora, you are not only a mentor, a very good friend, but your family to me. Thank you so much. At nais ko pong publicly pasalamatan din si Miss Beverly Sanbiero. Hindi niya alam, sana kanyari sa akin para mag-join at maging member ng Med Chorus. Thank you.
So two of the Met Chorus members you've heard from so far ended up in the priesthood, and the professions of all the other members are so varied. Right now, let's welcome Cherry Manzano. She is a publisher in a U.S. magazine, in a U.S. publishing house. She's an editor. Please welcome her.
Dito po yung publisher. I joined the Red Cross immediately after graduating from college. To be honest, that was in 1984, college. To give you an idea, lahat po kami over 50 years old. I was lucky to be accepted as one of the chorus members. And whether you were working or not, you had rehearsals every day, every single day. Whether may production or not. Pagkatapos, we were trained, like Father Nino said, we were trained to sing, dance, and act. I think we are one of the few choirs na Jacob Otrates. We were taught by the Met dancers. And sa mga productions po namin, may pit si Doktora at saka yung director ng show. Pag nasa stage ka, kailangan din character ka. Kahit na nangalating ulo mo, naiihi ka na, o kaya gusto mong bumahin, hindi ka pwedeng bumalaw. Freeze pala. And pag malapit na yung production, meron po kami what we call quartet exams. It's similar to the exams of maths. Tatayo kayo sa harap ni Doc, walang pyesa, kakantahin mo yung lahat ng songs din sa production. Si Doc po, bayonet at tenga. Kahit na nakatalikod siya, alam niya kung sino yung kumakanta at kung anong nota yung kinakanta na mali. She has 6 eyes at the back. Well, it was 4 at that time. Now that we've come together to rehearse again, I found out it was this. So, anyway, for us po, to be honest, tonight is a very special experience. This is the first time that the Met Chorus is singing again together after the Manila Metropolitan Theater closed down sa Adolfo in 1987. So we're very thankful that you're here to join us because for us, this is a very, what I call a very spiritual experience. You cannot realize how much fun. Siguro po pag nakita niyo yung Facebook page namin, makikita niyo, puro picture. Ang attendance record namin, picture taking. So, it has been a very joyful ride for all of us to be back together. And we hope that we will stay together for the future years to come. And we hope that Doctora, who will be living for Canada, she's now a resident of Canada, will visit us back here again to sing with us and to sing for you. Thank you. Go!
Thank you, Cherry. Some of those members of the Met Chorus that began there remained in the entertainment industry. Last but not the least, you've seen her on television, you've seen her on film. Please welcome the very vivacious Miss Beverly Salviejo.
Kailangan prevent proper na sa simbahan. Gaya po ni Father Nino, hindi naman ako talaga mag-audition. Nung boyfriend ko kasi noon, gusto niya mag-audition. Eh di ngayon, sabi, baka mamaya i-break ako kapag ako hindi si Mama. Di sinamahan ko mag-audition. Nakuha ako siya hindi. Pero ako na siya, reserve chorus. Kasi meron kami tinatawag na regular members. Yung regular members na yan, 24 lang yan, sa lahat ng production kasama. Yung regular paminsan-minsan lang. Ay, yung reserve, paminsan-minsan lang. Yung regular, yun ang regular na kasama sa lahat-lahat ng production. Ngayon, kasi nakakita siya ng mas maganda. Iniwan na yun ako, tumama doon sa maganda. Sabi ko ngayon, taga-US siya. Taga-USP ako. Father Nilo, si Father Benjo, si Isay Alvarez, si Angie Sebastian, sino pang mga tagay, si Monica, marami po kami. Tayo. Eh di siyempre, regular na ako. Di makeup ng makeup, we were very, very pampered at the Metropolitan. Kasi doon po ginagamitan kami ng mga magagaling na couturier. Victoria Moreno. Ramon Valera. Tama ba? Ano pa si Cruz? Pangalan. Basta malinig silang mga pangalan. Nalimutan ko na yun. That was 30 years ago. Anyway, kailangan ang gusto ni Tita Conchin, iingatan ang damit. Hindi ka po pwedeng kumain nang nakasuot ang damit. Kaya kailangan, kung halimbawa kakain ka lang, ikaw merong suot na bib. At hindi ka po pwede, hindi maganda. Eh kaso, kami ni Nag-Isay, gusto namin lagi kami maganda. Pag may bagong makeup, try namin. Hindi ko na realize na ako pala ay allergic sa napakaraming bagay. Gumamit kami ng bagong makeup on top of our Beautiful by Avon. Kasi may Avon ladies kami na yung pagkanda nila. Kaya kami gusto namin, what? Gamitin pa namin ito. Habang nasa stage kami, oh, saan pong kating ang mukha? Pagkatapos ng show, hindi ko na po kaya, usually noon, kahit na lumabas pa kami, naka-makeup ako para makapamaganda, di ba? Ngayon, ang hinugasan ko, pagkatapos ng show, nakita ko, violet na yung ganito. Kasi allergic po ako doon sa ginamit na makeup, yung bagong makeup. Pagkatapos, sabi, akala ko mawawala. Pagkatapos ng ilang araw, mga isang linggo na dumadami sila. Parami. Patong-patong na sila. Sa isang pinpoy, lima ang mata. What happened to your face? I was allergic to the cosmetics that I use. But hey, what? No, Tita, another, you should not use that. Sabi ngayon sa akin ng aming production manager, bakit kasi hindi ka nalang pagpaderma? Wala akong kilali. Okay, eto, punta ka dito ha. Eto, dermato magaling dito. Kaya lang, pupunta ka dyan maaga pa. Kasi kapag kayong pumunta ka dyan ng mga bandang 7, marami ng tao. Pumunta po ako ng alas-alis. Number 25 na ako. Noong natin makagay, tiniris. Paglabas ko talaga ng paglabas ko ng dermatologist. Dumuhan po ako. Literally. After 1 month, wala na po akong pimple. Mukha na lang. Experience dito sa web na napakaganda. I would like to acknowledge the presence of one of our friends here, Pico Del Rosario, who is our mayor. Kaya kundisyon kasama sa akin dahil sa kita na Pampanga, mahirap po mag-rehearse sa pagkaganyan na luwas siya ng luwas. But anyway, from the Metropolitan Theater, we graduated to magsimula ka. And then he graduated to Miss Saigon, Germany. Marami po pagamit ko ang nagpumunta po sa Miss Saigon, hindi lang po si Isay Alvarez, hindi lang si John Briones, there were a host of others, probably half of us, ay napunta po sa Miss Saigon. Kaya po, makikita po ninyo, magagaling po talaga sina. Komedyante, kasi nakita nila, alam niyo po, I was 70 pounds. You could just imagine how small I was. Sa stage, itinagbabakubakuhan ko ng mga dancers. Dahil sabi nila yun, pag nag-good time ng mga dancers, nag-good time talaga yan, sinasagda talaga ako, pinagdaganyanan ako, ginagawa ko akong basketball. Sa likit ko, I was 70 pounds, ang aking bewang ay 19. Ganon ako ang likit. So anyway, Noong maliit na maliit ako ganun. Si Bicong ang aking naging partner. Si Father Lilo. Si Father Benjo, hindi. Si Father Benjo ay naging kaklasko po sa USC at hanggang ngayon magkaibigan po kami. Pero I remember him yung marami pa siyang buho. Mukhang gul. Hanggang ngayon po, walang naniniwala, marunong ako. Sana po kayong lahat na dito ngayon, naniniwala na kayo.
Thank you so much for sharing those wonderful anecdotes, Father Nilo, Father Benjo, Cherry, and Beverly. The next numbers you will hear this evening are a medley from Sarumbanggi, Minamahal Kita, Pandanguhan. Please welcome back the Manila Metropolitan Theater Chorus.
Oh! ay makibig ko sa mga pagsuminaan. Kung hindi taos, ay makibig ko sa mga pagsuminaan.
Masyadong masera ang parang sa sinubiwa.
Our love of country.